Hi guys, Lady Random here, and welcome back to Feed the Beast Inventions. Okay, a few things I want to get done today. It is dark out, so let's just sleep the night off very quickly. A few things I want to do. How much of it we get done depends on how long some of this actually takes. But we're talking in the last episode about Steve's carts, and hi! And that's kind of what I wanted to get cracking on with today. So I'll start to put a few bits together. So we need, if we just go to, okay, so the first thing, the cart assembler, which is stone, iron, and the simple PCBs. PCBs are great, you can either do it one or two ways. So it's basically four redstone, four iron, and a gold. So we need a couple of them. So let's stick those together. Like a sir. Ooh, what does that actually make? A map control module. Okay. Fair enough. At least we know that. Okay, so that gives us our two PCBs. And then we have our stone and our iron. So it should go like this, is that right? No, they need to be there like that, don't they? Right, let's double check this. We'll work on them right in the first place. There we go. Like that. So that is our cart assembler. Now, it's something that does need power. So I'm not sure, actually, whether it takes RF or whether it takes... I think it takes power, but we'll stick it there anyway. So we need to add a cart hull of our choice into here. So let's look at hull. So we're going to look to do just a standard hull, I think, which is iron and iron wheels. And the iron wheels are dead easy to make. So let us grab ourselves some sticks and grab ourselves a bit of iron out of there. So that makes one set of wheels. We need two sets of wheels. Okay, so we need to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, and 1, 2. So there's two sets of wheels. Let's knock together our standard cart hull. Now you see with that, it's got a modular capacity of 200. So you can have three engines and six add-ons. So our module complexity cap is also 50. So this gives us the limit as to what types of add-ons we can actually put into this. So let's put our cart in here like so. So we are ready to assemble the cart. So at the moment, we've got a hull capacity of 200, complexity capacity of 50. Total cost at the moment, we've not added anything to it yet. And it's going to take about 5 seconds to build. The more you add on to these, the more it actually takes to build the cart itself. So the next thing I want to do is put together just a standard standard coal engine is what I want. So that is iron like so, two pistons and a furnace, I believe. So that's modular cost of 15. Oh, obviously decided to take both of our furnaces, so we can now put our engine into here. And you can see now we've got total cost of 15, which is fine, and it's going to take 1 minute 41 seconds to build that. So the next thing I wanted to put on there was the storage for this, and I'm going to take this out in this way just so I can remember what goes where. So we should be able to go back to Steve's carts. We're looking to put on this here, which is our storage. And go. I think we can shift right click it, but yeah, I kind of cocked that up slightly. Stick the bits in there. Okay, and we also need as I've just noticed, this item here. So if we go back into it, which is the lock, and I forgot all about the lock, which is this here. Dead simple again. So we'll put our lock together. That gives us 8 chest locks. We don't need 8, we just need the 1. So I think it was this way around. Find out in a sec. Yeah, there we go. So that's our side chests modular upgrade. So storage, we can put that into there. So you can see now we're up to a total cost of 18, and it's going to take 1 minute 44. Okay, we also want to have our blades, because we'll actually be using this as our tree farm. So the blades, again, fairly expensive because it involves diamonds. But there we go, that gives us a saw blade, which we should be able to put on to attachments, I think. Nope, is it add-ons? Ooh. Tool. Are you a tool? How do we put on our saw blade? Ooh. Is it something that goes down here? Because I would think it should go into tool. So you can see we've got our engine on there, which is there. See our tool slot. Why are you not allowing me to put that in there? Okay. So it's not an attachment. What I will do, I will check this out, find out where we're going wrong, and I will be right back. See you in a sec. And we are back. Right, okay, we have actually found out what it is we're supposed to build, and that is this, which is the basic woodcutter. So for that we actually need 5 of the saw blades. Ouchie. An iron ingot and a wood cutting core. Pretty easy wood cutting core. We just need saplings around an advanced PCB. So that is a bunch of PCBs that we actually need for that. So we need 2 normal PCBs. So let us make that very quickly. So it was 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. And I think we actually needed 2 extra of those as well, didn't we? I think we're always going to use these, so there we go. Okay. So let's just check our recipe again. So that is iron, redstone, 2 of those. There we go, that is our advanced PCB. Let's grab ourselves some saplings. We've got a bunch of oak saplings here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those. So we need to put that in the middle and those around the outside. That gives us our wood cutting core. So then it is simply this, and 5 saw blades, and that gives us our basic wood cutting core, which we can now add as a tool, I believe. There we go. So we've got our blades on the front, we've got our storage, and we've got our engine. So that's going to take 11 minutes. I mean, what we could do is eventually we could actually put our cart in, rebuild it, and actually put some fuel tanks on there. But this will give us the chest for the storage. So we're ready to assemble. So there we go. So that is now going to think about that and take quite a bit of time, I think, to actually make that. Now, is that actually needing power? Okay, where's my cart? Where's my cart? Ooh. Why, for you know, give me my cart. We've clicked assemble. Oh, there we go, look. We haven't got any fuel. We need fuel. Can we take some out of our generator? Will it take normal fuel? There we go. So that is now going to start assembling our cart. Yes, I thought we probably did need some. So it obviously doesn't take any power from here. So maybe we haven't actually... Let's set that to pull from there. Active without signal. I wonder whether that will... Will that give it some power? Doesn't look like it. Okay. So I think we're going to have to leave that in there. Oh, it's because that hasn't got anything. Dear, oh dear, oh dear. Let's stick in a stack of logs into that. And start getting that generating. Still going down. That's powering that up. Okay. That's something for something else that we actually need as well. Haha. Which we will maybe if we get time to show you later. So yeah, there we go. That is our cart assembling. Hopefully we've got enough fuel. If we haven't, we shall come back. So stick our Steve's cart bits into here. So just jump into bed again quickly, just so it's not so evil out there. And show you what we've actually got set up out here. Okay, so a little bit of a farm going on there now. Get rid of this one. So as you can see, we've got a load of track laid down. And this is going to be the basis of our farm. So the idea is we'll be placing saplings around the track. The cart will come along, it will chop those saplings down, store them all up, and what we need is somewhere where it can actually pick up fuel and drop off the wood and the saplings. So that is what we're going to look at next. Let's move those out of the way. So we've now completed that chest. So you can go. So for this part here, this is to make our let's go back to here, cargo manager. So this is the cargo manager. So this is the thing we can use to unload and load the cart. Okay, so for that we need huge iron panes, large iron panes, and a large dynamic pane. Now the large iron panes are made up of iron panes, which are chest panes. And yeah, it's always a good thing, isn't it, talking about having chest panes, but there we go. That is simply just sort of a sort of sideways H of planks with logs either side of it. That will give you 32 chest panes. And then all you need to do is surround an iron ingot with those. That will give you 8 iron panes. And then to make your large iron pane, you take 4 of your iron panes. And then for your huge iron pane, it'll be 9 of those. So that is that. So let us put together this here, which is the dynamic pane. Dynamic pane is basically redstone with an iron pane. So that's how you make those. So let's grab those down to make the large one of them. So that is one large dynamic pane. And then these are the plates that we actually need to make our actual machine itself. And I think it was large ones there. There we go. So that is our cargo manager. Now that will need powering. So I have got a Stirling generator at the ready for that. Hopefully it does work on RF. We'll soon find out if it doesn't, won't we? And the last thing that we needed was detector rails to tell the cart to actually stop in order to unload So we need, where's our pressure plates? There. And that give us two detector rails. Now at the moment we're actually only going to need the one. Just because we're going to operate the one. Oh, hello, witchy. See if we can get rid of you very quickly, because I really don't want you throwing anything nasty at me. There we go. Don't think she's dropped anything. Oh, she's dropped a little bit of gunpowder, but that's fine. We'll come back to that another point. So why don't we take out this rail here, and we'll replace that with one of our detector rails. And what we'll do is pop our cargo manager down here, and we'll see if our generator actually works. Now it looks like our coke oven has finished, so that's not a bad thing. We can start charging this little baby up. So what this does, it gives us a little bit of an interface. You see the cargo manager has different sides. I'm wondering whether we actually need to bury this underneath it, but you've got a red side, you have a blue side, you have a yellow side, and you have a green side. Now the side our cart's going to be stopping on is the yellow side, so that's the side that we actually need to play with. So let's make them all yellow size. What is this doing here? Change it to a yellow side. Yellow side. And yellow side. Finally get there. So this is stuff going into the cart. This is stuff coming out of the cart. So stuff going into the car is where we're going to want fuel going in. The stuff coming out is where we're going to want saplings. Don't know how we can get rid of this. Let's put this back to the cart again, which would be clever. There we go. So we will want stuff coming out will be saplings. And stuff going into the cart will be the coal. So we need to fill this side up with coal. That side will fill up with all of our stuff. Or that is at least the plan. Okay, let's just take this tree down. There'll be some more charcoal that we can use. There we go. Let's stick those into there. Now what I was actually planning to use for fuel, to start with, is something where it is actually slightly better. We have got some charcoal there, but this stuff here, coal coke, I actually found a little bit, if you remember from the previous series, in the chests in the mine shaft. And this stuff, now you look at your normal charcoal, you've got a burn time of 1600, and this doubles, and this is basically coal that has gone through the coke oven, so it actually makes a better source of fuel, so you actually get more time out of your coal. So it does kind of, I suppose it doubles the resource really. So what we can do is actually put that into here, and that is the stuff that is going to be going into the cart. So this is charging up beautifully, so hopefully this will work. What I don't know is, let's have a look, so it needs to be active without signal, and we want it to push energy, I guess, into this. I think it needs power anyway. We'll soon find out. So we'll let that carry on building up, and we'll go and see how our cart is getting on. Okay, let's have a look. How is our cart doing? Okay, so very nearly there. We are running a little bit low on fuel, so why don't we... we've got those 32 in there, haven't we? Let's stick... let's actually just check our IO on this, because I've got a feeling that we may have had this set up wrong. We need it to push. Is that building the... No. It does obviously need to run on a solid fuel. Okay, that's fine. We can stick a couple of more bits in there. So at 91%. Very nearly there. Okay, well, this will give us an excuse just to maybe go and pop, while that's finishing, a few trees down. Just so you can sort of have a bit of an idea of what this is going to be doing. Put just a few down for the time being. You can have some there. But yeah, that will give you an idea of how the cart's going to work. How are we getting on? 98%? One more bit of fuel. Hopefully should do it. 99. 2, 1. Boom. There we go. So there is our cart made by us. Aren't we clever? Okay, let's stick that into there. So this is our cart. See, our cart needs fueling. So we pop it here. What should happen? There you go. You can see it's picked up the fuel, which is good. Which means that is powered up. And why are you not going? There he goes. So you can see he's going to trundle along quite happily now. And it could probably do with a little bit of bone meal. Do we have a bone? Just so we can try and get the trees grown quickly. That's our mob chest, isn't it? Just grab a little bit of bone meal. Let's see if we can't get a couple of the trees up and growing. So we sit, watch here. So he's fueled up again. What in theory should happen, it might be that the placing of the tree isn't quite right for that, but what it should do is not chop down the tree at all. Interesting. Why are you not chopping down the tree? I do wonder if it's because it is on a corner, and I wonder whether it can't actually chop on corners. So let's gather those back, and we'll pop 1, 2, 3 more down there. Because that kind of would make sense, wouldn't it? Typically need our trees to grow. Let's go and sleep and let's see if we can't get a tree to grow in the meantime. Okay, I'm just wondering whether we've got any more bone meal already. Bone meal, apparently not. Right, let's grab those then. Let's bone meal ourselves some trees. More saplings there. try 1, 2, 3. There we go. See you. I'm spacing out a little bit. 1, 2, 3. Doesn't seem to want to cut our trees down. So my understanding is that that should actually be stopping and cutting our trees. But it appears that that is not the case. Right, let's... We've got our woodcutter. Is on. I wonder whether we need to actually configure our cart. Let's just take his... Oh, come back. When he comes back round, we'll take his fuel out. Whether we actually need to do something, because that should he's still got his fuel in there. Let's take your fuel. So he's definitely stopping. He's definitely going. Why is he not? Why is he not cutting? Maybe we have to tell it what we want it to cut. To cut these. Okay. Let's have a think. And I will think I will go and have another quick looky at the wikia on this and we will see what we can figure out. So we'll see you in a sec. And we are back. Yeah, we figured out what the problem was. And what it is, we were trying to use the acacia trees. Now, to use that, we actually needed to create an exotic sort of add-on for it, so it recognises the exotic trees. So that would have been glowstone dust, oak saplings, redstone, simple PCBs, and then your empty disc is made with a PCB and redstone. But obviously, because we've now assembled our cart, we no longer have the ability to be able to modify it. But if you watch now, you can see it's busy sawing away there, chopping down those trees. So that is where our issue is. So it does mean that we are going to need to use vanilla oak at the moment. But okay, that's not a massive problem. We don't get quite the yield that we get with the others, but as you can see, it kind of goes along quite happily and it will unload. Hopefully, will it unload? Oh, it's picking up the fuel, we're just needing to get it to unload as well. So I think that's right. So let's have a look in the cart itself. Yes, it's picking up apples. So I don't know whether we actually need to tell it. Currently railers. Currently storage slots. There we go. So hopefully, is that going to unload? So it's doing something. Going into the cart, we need to go into the engine. Is that right? And that comes around again. busy chopping down the trees. I think it's replanting them as well, isn't it, by the looks of things? The saplings. Right, now are you going to unload? You see, we need to make this going in, don't we? So from the cargo manager into the chest. We need to reverse this, don't we? Set that to cart again. Ah, there we go. See, look. Now we are transfer. Why is that transferring stuff? Oh, there we go. Zombie dying on the fence. So chests into there. Now, is it using the logs as fuel, I wonder? Let's have a look when it comes around again. Yeah, it has been. Cheeky, cheeky. So we want those in this side. It's nicking all my wood back again. So it's currently going to the cart. It's going from the cart. And we want... So I wonder whether we can... So it's changing the side. Continue along off transfer. Continue along off transfer. Continue along off transfer. Yes. The stuff going into the cart, we just want it to go into the engine. We want out of the storage chest. Into the cargo manager. Let me check. I'll be right back. Right, so it kind of seems to be it's a case that he will carry on tramping around while he needs fuel. So he's going to need to fill his fuel slots up. But you'll see he'll start to actually sort of fill up with everything he's got, with the saplings, etc, etc. And so he's having a ponder over it. So he's now fueling himself by the looks of things. Let's see when he stops. What's he running on? Well, he's got enough fuel, it seems. So we can now sort of leave everything pretty much to run. Hopefully he'll come back and he'll take his coke. But he should also run on saplings once he's actually got going. So let's see what he does now. He'll take that. Hi. Oh, that does work so well. There we go. You can see he's loading up again. Why don't we change that to saplings? I should hope stop. I should load him up with any saplings in there. And he'll just run on that. So all good. So you can see it's kind of now trundling along quite well. So he'll carry on, he'll plant saplings as he goes. As you can hear him doing that. And yeah, he'll basically keep going round and round and round and round. How are we doing for that? We are doing okay. So gradually he'll be at a point where he doesn't actually need to take any more of the wood. He'll fill himself up with what he needs into his engine. And he'll carry on going. So it's going to take a little while. So once we actually get the trees going, him chopping, etc, etc, it will start sort of stocking up. And once all of his fuel slots are actually filled, then everything will keep going very, very nicely with that. So that should start working rather nicely. Right, let's take that. Let's go and grab another stack of our old acacia logs. There we go. Stick those in. So that's now going to basically just keep running and running and running. Yes, we'll have to come and check on our cargo manager and grab out sort of the stuff as it comes in. We'll take the apples as it's there. So any surplus wood that we actually get, we can grab that. And we can just come and stick that in our chest here. That is pretty much... Ooh, we filled up. Exciting. That's pretty much everything that we need to do as far as our Steve's Carts farm goes. Let's pop our fuel into there. Okay, a little bit difficult to judge on time because we have been messing around rather a lot. But I kind of think we are going to call it there. I think we've got as much done as we can. We'll save these extra bits here for another episode. But I hope you enjoyed it. A little bit derpy, I suppose, because we kind of weren't quite getting to grips with what we think we're supposed to be doing. But there we go. Our little car is going to be... Hi, Mr. Creeper. Yay! Gets rid of you as well. Happy days. As our cart stopped, that's because he's busy chopping. He is busy chopping. This is good. You see, now the farm's starting to run a little bit better. Don't think we actually need fuel by the looks of things. This doesn't appear to be taking it, so let's take this away. I think that should probably carry on quite nicely on its own. And it does mean that we actually have got a generator we can use for something else, so we can stick that away quite nicely. But there we go. One tree farm. So, a little bit derpy, as I said, but I hope you all enjoyed the episode. Hope you found it useful. This is my first dip into Steve's Carts, and you can probably tell, could probably have done with doing a little bit more research than I did. But we got there in the end. So thank you all very much for watching, and we shall see you in the next one. Take care.